Now, Katie Price is not only a TV personality, model and author, but she's also a mum of five, juggling life in the spotlight. Ange sat down with her to talk all things marriage, kids, and to get all the details on her upcoming projects and cosmetic procedures.
Katie, so good to see you. You are looking a million bucks. You tell me you're ready to get in the bath and this is you. You look incredible.
I promise you I am. I had a massage today, so I've got oil in my hair. I've got the kids next to me here. You probably can't see. Waiting to get in the bath because obviously it's 9 o'clock at night here. But it is what it is. And I have just had surgery, so I'm still recovering. So,
well, if you're recovering, you're an ad. Oh, hello, sweetheart. You're an ad for looking amazing. Look at your
look. Say hi, bunny. They're in Australia. What do you think?
How far? The other side
of the world.
Can't get any further.
Exactly. And when you put the water down the plug, it goes the other way round when you're there.
What time is it there?
Six in the morning. Are you overtaking my interview here? Are you bombarding? Oh, whatever. Sorry.
What surgery did you have? What did you decide to do?
Well, basically, I broke my feet last year in a freakish accident. So it left me. I'm normally really small, and I was in a wheelchair for 8 months, and obviously not been able to move around. And my age, I put on weight, and I'm not able to run again. So I couldn't go for running because I love running. So I haven't been able to go to the gym, and I was trying to eat healthy, and I just couldn't shift my weight. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to have lipo done. And just a little bit done on my face. Why not? I'm 43. I'm not in my 20s. Wait a minute, Bunny. So what I had done, I had a lip lift because, you know, sometimes when you have lip filler, it looks too ducky. You know, a lot of girls at the minute in their early 20s, they're having far too much, like Botox filler, and they look like puffer fishes. Now, I'm 43, so I am entitled to do what I want now. I'm old enough. And I did my whole career with my face natural, apart from the boobs. So what I had done, it's a cat eye. You probably see the scars there still healing and a bit here.
Just faintly, really faintly.
Yeah, and then under here, if you look closely, can you see? Yeah, it's still healing. It's called a lift lip. So what they do, they cut there and they just lift your lip a little bit. So, yeah.
Did it hurt?
That's what I'd done. Do you know what? The face doesn't actually. It's just itchy. Do you know what I mean? It just gets itchy. Right, Bunny just wants to show you our new little buddy. Sorry about this. Buddy, hello. There you go. Teacup chihuahua. Right, Bunny, you can go away now. Thank you. All right, you hold him. So, yeah, I had that done, lipo, and when they took some fat out of me, I had some put in my bum, so I thought I'd see what that's like. Because normally I'm small. Well, my mum had a go at me. Why have you done this? What have you done to yourself? I'm like, Mum, I'm 43. I could do what I like. It's ridiculous, she goes to me. But if I don't like it, I can have it sucked back out.
Is so, it good?
I know I'm crazy.
Take it out. It's easy.
but I have done on my YouTube, actually, the seriousness of it. My YouTube coming out, I filmed the whole lot before surgery. Because when you see it on TV, you don't really see what happens. You might see surgeons in showing what they want to show, but you never see what happens after surgery, the recovery. You always see before and after pictures. So I thought I'd take people on a journey to let you know that when you have surgery or any operation, it isn't just a walk in the park. It is serious. You know, you're put to sleep and you do have to recover and you are in pain. And, you know, I had this done on the 17th of June. And I'm still swollen, I'm still sore, but it is serious when you have a procedure. I don't want people to think I'm going to go and do this, it's easy. But I'm knowledgeable enough and I've had operations to know what I'm doing. But you do need to look into it and look into what surgeons you go for.
Yes, you've got to go to someone who's a real surgeon, the real deal, don't you? So important.
Yeah, you definitely hear horror stories, yeah. I went to Turkey for mine, so comfort zone, they're good.
Yeah.
How Little did club you... for them.
Yeah, absolutely. So we can watch all of this on your YouTube channel coming up soon.
Yeah. Yeah, it's coming soon. They're just editing it because there's so many gruesome bits. And I have to remember my kids might watch it, you know, the other kids. I mean, I don't mind people seeing me like it because it's real and that's what it is. Even Carl went over there. He was going to have lipo. Carl's my fiance. We'll talk about him in a minute. He was going to have lipo done. Not that he needs it. But then he was all ready to go down, had the cannula in and everything. And then as soon as he saw me come up the lift, he went, no way am I doing this. No way. Because he got to see what it's really like. And he said, I don't know how you women do this. And so he's been to the gym since. And I said, see, you didn't need it after all.
Now, nothing was off limits when Ange sat down with Katie Price, a.k.a. Jordan. She even introduced us to her new fiancé.
If you've got the balls, Cole, come over and say hello. And he'll be like, no, I haven't done my hair. Come say hello. Let the Australians see you.
Yeah. A little butt.
No, no butts. Come on, this is as natural as it gets. Quick.
Natural.
So, everyone. Oh, go on, then. This
hello.
Is Cole.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
And you, how are you?
Yeah, really good. Are you excited that with the big day coming up? Lots of planning to do?
Oh, well, of course I am. I get to marry her.
Oh. He's the only one to put up with me, I can tell you.
No, he's all the right things. Are you going to be a bit of a groomzilla?
Do you know what? I think the best thing I can do is let Kate take over. Just hopefully she turns up, eh?
Of course. Kids, I'm on the phone. Quiet.
I'll let you get on. It was lovely to meet you.
So nice to meet you and congratulations. We look forward to seeing the big day.
Aww.
Thank you.
That's the engagement ring as well, if you haven't seen it.
Gorgeous. Wow. Yeah. How many carats is that?
I actually don't know. How many carats? Seven carats. Jet, turn that off. Seven carats. So, yes. So, the wedding, I don't know what we're going to do yet. But we are going to... Obviously, my mum's terminally ill as well. So, I want to do it and I want her to see the wedding. I mean, there's just so much going on in my life. You know, I've just done the documentary with Harvey. I can't wait. He's up for a nomination for the show. He doesn't understand that, but to get a TV award for that would be amazing. And not only that, just to see what he'll be like on stage, because he'll probably get everyone to do a picture for his iPad and to walk up the red carpet with him. Oh, it's an amazing achievement. And we've just starting to film our second one now of him going to college.
That is so great because it's so inspirational to see what you and Harvey have achieved and what Harvey has achieved.
For people who are watching and they don't quite know my backlog of my story, my son was born blind with septic optic dysplasia. He's got autism, Prader-Willi, you know, lots of complex disabilities. And he's turned 18, and I don't know what it's like in your country, but over here, everything changes when you're 18.
You've got five beautiful kids. We've seen two of them there today. Are you planning on more? Are you thinking about more?
Of course. I mean, some people stop at two. Not me. I've had five, so why not continue? You know, I've decided as they get older and then, you know, they leave the house, and I'm just so nurturing. But because I've had four cesareans, they only recommend three. But I have seen a gynecologist and they said that I would be able to have another one. If not, I would do surrogacy, get someone to... Because I'm not finished yet. I definitely want more babies. But when you get old, I might look younger and act younger, but our bodies inside are getting old, whether we like it or not. So the next baby I have, I will have to do IVF. I already know that. So that's another journey and... something else I'll be talking about.
When they see someone with a profile like yours, I really think it does help people when you share things like that, when you share all of these stories. You've had the life. You are having the life. So much happens to you.
Oh, I know. Tell me about it. Like you say, like, people might knock me and, you know, some people might not love me or they might hate me. But I do say having a celebrity status does help things. Like you might have heard about my laws that I'm doing. I did Harvey's law and my new law, Track a Troll, which basically it should be worldwide. I'm trying to make a new law and I've just got nearly under 1 million signatures now. So it will have to go to Parliament to be debated.
Brilliant.
That, you know, online trolling is massive for absolutely everyone. Everyone, whether it's racism, whatever sex you are, it could be in the workplace, at school. You get these keyboard warriors who bully people. People who've committed suicide is so high now, especially through the lockdown, that I think that trolls should be able to be tracked. So what I'm trying to do is that any social media that people enter. I think the social medias should be responsible to take details. Like if you go and get a house or a car, they want to know everything about you. So I think social media should be responsible to take people's address, ID, phone numbers, so you can track them. I do talk a lot, don't I? I could take over your whole 4-hour show.
Which we would love anytime. When you can travel again, bring the whole tribe. Come and take over the whole couch. It would be amazing.
Talking of this, talking of travelling, I hear that Katie Hopkins has been deported from Australia. Can I say something? Why would you want her on your Big Brother? You've got the wrong lady there. It should have been me, because I was with Katie Hopkins' Big Brother. When I did Big Brother over here, I was in it with Katie. And I'm sorry to say, guys, she's vile. She's not allowed on any TV in England anymore because of the way she is. So when I found out she was on Big Brother over there, although she'd be entertaining to watch, I'm glad she's not doing it.
It has been so good to catch up with you, and we will do it again soon. When's the big day? When's the wedding date?
We haven't planned it yet because I've got TV I'm filming all through the summer. So, but towards the end of the year, imagine that, a nice winter wonderland wedding. How nice would that be, like in the winter, and have like snow or fake snow and all romantic, nice. And I want to come back to Australia. I said, Nicole, we've got to go to Australia, and then I can sit there with you in person.
That is a date. That is definitely a date.